Vibha Rawat, Assistant Professor in RPIIT Medical and Technical Campus. Today, I am going to discuss with you another basic and important chapters of the electrochemistry, that is the redox reaction. So, talking about the redox reaction, what do you mean by redox? So, redox, the word itself tells us that redox is a combination of two words, red and ox, where this red word stands for reduction and ox word stands for oxidation. And talking about what is reduction, what is oxidation? So reduction is basically the gain of electrons. When the oxidation states, you know, it decreases, that is called reduction. But in case of oxidation, the word itself means it favors the oxidation process. That is the increase in the number of oxygen atoms or the loss of electrons. So that is called the oxidation. Now, reactions which involve oxidation and reduction reaction as its two half reactions means the reaction in which both the processes oxidation and reduction that takes place as its two half reaction. Two half reaction means on one side oxidation is being done and on the other side, on the other half side, the reduction is being done. A redox reaction, a redox change occurs simultaneously. Means whenever we talk about the redox reactions, if half of the site is undergoing oxidation and the other half is going to reduction, so these both the two processes, they take place simultaneously, that is all together. Now, no net change in the number of electrons and there is no net change in the number of electrons in redox reactions. Means whenever we carry out the redox reaction, there is no net change in the number of charges. Means if we take about a neutral substance and we undergo the process of reduction, so the final products will be also sort of reduced substance, means they also carry the same charges as the reactants were carrying. So there is overall there is no change in the net charge. Moving on, let's take the examples. I'll be discussing with you the two examples. One of them is the formation of magnesium oxide. So talking about the magnesium, when we oxidize magnesium, it gets oxidized by losing two electrons at a time to its plus 2 oxidation state, which is the Mg2+. That is, on losing two electrons means it lost two electrons and it got oxidized. Means this particular term is acting as the reducing agent. And whenever the things get oxidized, whenever the elements get oxidized, its oxidation state increases from 0 to plus 2. That is, there is an increase in the positive charge. Increase in the positive charge as can be shown by the example, that is magnesium. It was earlier carrying 0 charge. It was neutral in nature, but later on it became a cation. A cation is a positively charged ion. Similarly, talking about the oxygen, this oxygen got reduced. How it got reduced? By the addition. I shall mark these signs like addition. By the addition of 4 electrons, because it is a complete molecule in which there are 2 oxygen atoms. So, this complete molecule on gaining 4 electrons, it got changed into 2 nascent oxygen atoms with each minus 2 charge. So, the oxidation state here, it got reduced from 0 to minus 2. So this process is called the reduction, and there is decrease in the negative charge. So there is decrease in the negative charge. Sorry, it will be the decrease in the positive charge, or we can say the decrease in the charge, because if we talking about the negative charges, it is not decreasing, because it is rather increasing in this case. If we take the example of this, so it is rather increasing. So this will known as the reduction. But here in this case, it is the decrease in the positive charge or the increase in negative charge is called the reduction. Now, but if we talk about the balancing, as I stated earlier, that there is no net change in the number of electrons, or there is no net change in the charge. So the balancing is required for this case, because here we took the case of 4 electrons and here we are talking about 2 electrons. So 2 of Mg, that is in the solid state, they on losing 4 electrons, its state changes from Mg2+, that to 2 molecules, and 4 of electrons, such that these 4 electrons are gained by the oxygen atom. And this particular thing means, if you consider these, this is the advanced reaction, we can call it. So this, if we call it, it is 1, and if we call it as 2, so on combining both means these 4 electrons which are given out by the magnesium ion, they are taken by the oxygen molecule, and then the overall reaction becomes like this, means 2 of Mg as said by this plus oxygen will take this, because if you write this as, then it is O2 plus 4 of electrons moves out in the form of 2 nascent oxygen with minus 2 charges. So here these 2 gets cancelled out, so we are adding this 2 only, means this side will be adding Mg and O2, this is Mg and O2, and on the right hand side we will be having 2Mg 2 plus, and this overall, this will, when this will combine, it will form 2 of MgO. So this is the resultant. So this particular overall reaction is nothing but the redox reaction. Talking about another example, that is the formation of MgCl2, magnesium chloride. Now here again the magnesium is getting oxidized, because its oxidation state is changing from 0 to plus 2 oxidation state on losing 2 electrons, so this particular reaction is again but the oxidation reaction. And here in this case it is gaining 2 electrons, and its oxidation state is changing from 0 to minus 1, because it is a complete molecule, so it is getting reduced. So overall reaction is, because here the case is between the 2 electrons only, means it's about the 2 electrons only. So these 2 electrons which are given out by the magnesium ion, they are taken by the chloride ions, and so that the overall reaction becomes this, Mg is 2 of, because we are taking 2 molecules, Mg, 2 of Mg plus Cl2 reacts to give MgCl2. This is the overall reaction, which is called as the redox reaction. Now, what are oxidizing and reducing agents? In these particular 2 examples, if we talk about the oxidizing agents are these substances which oxidize, means which undergo, which enables a process of reduction. They themselves, they got reduced, and this reduction process was carried out. So they are called oxidizing agents. So they are the oxygen and the chlorine. Whereas talking about the reducing agents are these who themselves got reduced in order to carry out the process of oxidation. I hope this video is very much clear to you, and if you have got any of the doubts, please do write in the comment box, and please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.